So it's been a while since I've done a video, and my next video was actually going to be about my Sinatra Imperial winning first place and about the interior. That will be the next video, hopefully. We'll see. I wanted to get a video of this Mark V that I actually picked up yesterday. I had a Mark V many, many years ago, and I sold it, and it was a mistake. My wife knew that it was a mistake, and told me recently that, hey, you know, if you find another one, you know, you should get it. And over the recent years, Mark V's have been going way up in price, and it's like, I'm not spending that much on a Mark V. On an extra car when we don't need any extra cars, right? And so last week I was on Craigslist and I saw this one pop up. I had seen it pop up occasionally for years, and the former owner had it for years. It didn't pass smog. Something happened with it. I don't know. We'll figure it out. But anyway, I got in contact, and they told me it runs and all that. In this video, I won't have it running yet because there's an interesting situation with the battery, which we'll get into in a minute. But anyway, I want another Mark V. And this one's actually a designer edition, which these are very rare. This is a Pucci edition, Mark V, 1978, finished in dove gray. And the vinyl top's actually supposed to be a black kind of snakeskin look. Someone replaced it at some point, but when I go back to replace it, I will replace it with the proper one. But anyway, I made contact with the owner, and I said, well, does it run? Does it move back and forth? You know, I want to be able to pull it in my driveway, so on and so forth. I didn't want something that didn't run, like the good old Studebaker that I rescued, at least to where I could pull it in. And I say, yeah, it runs and everything. And so anyway, I went back and forth, a little bit of negotiation, and I went down yesterday and picked this up with the tow truck. The gentleman nicely agreed to an excellent price for it, and he had it sitting in a parking garage underneath an apartment complex for quite some time. And so given the rarity of the designer editions, I thought, you know, this is pretty good. So I wanted to go ahead and take a video before I actually clean it up. This is dirt that's probably about 10 years old or 8 years old. He's had it he got it back in 2014. And there's our engine compartment there. All the fluids are clean, surprisingly. Looks pretty good. Like I said, I'll be cleaning this down in a while with a pressure washer. Gotta love the old hoods, you know. We'll just leave that like that. But anyway, this is all dirt that's like, yeah, this is like barn find, except it's a, how should I put this? It's a parking garage find, because it was in a parking garage, so it's not quite a barn find. But anyway, the paint is actually pretty good under here. We may be able to save it, at least for now. It was repainted at some point. See, there's a couple of these around. But yeah, so this is like the first car I've ever gotten that was a barn find, except a parking garage find. But these Pucci Mark V's are pretty hard to find, actually very hard to find. And so anyway, I went down there and my wife bought it for me for my birthday, which is very nice of her. I have one of those milestone birthdays coming up, and she asked me what I won, and that's always a dangerous question. My answer is always a car. And But anyway, so I went down there yesterday and picked it up. I'll share some pictures of that. But it's in pretty darn good shape. There's a couple little rust spots here. There's one here and a couple around, which we'll take a look at. But the vinyl top's actually pretty decent. There's some cracks and things in it. But because it's the Landau top, it won't be too hard to get it replaced nor expensive, which is good because it's only partial. Also, we won't have to worry about very much rust because it's a partial top and not a full top. So I went down there and the car started and drove it around the parking garage and then it sputtered out. And I was like, oh boy. The guy kept telling me about the battery and this and that, and it's like, yeah, the battery's old, clearly, and there's some interesting things with that. And also, I think that it's completely out of gas now. But it started up just on the first turn, so I was like, oh, this is great. So I told him, yeah, I'll go ahead and take it. And the former owner was very pleased and very happy that it was going to a good home because he liked the car a lot. And so, anyway, so I brought this home yesterday. The tow truck actually arrived in 15 minutes. Couldn't believe it. And like I said, it's very filthy right now. But once this is all cleaned up, it'll be pretty good. And of course, we have some 1970s equipment on here. This was like a CB radio antenna. Yeah. So I'm going to figure out some way of covering that over. And at least for now, a couple things. Also has a trailer hitch, which on my old Mark V, I actually removed it. But I may just leave it on this one. Yeah, on my old Mark V, the previous owners, who were my aunt's parents, they used to haul a horse trailer with it. So I actually may leave this on there. I'll get a new ball on there and like clean it up. But it's always handy to be able to tow something. So obviously we have some small things, you know, the Mark V emblem here, which needs to be fixed. A couple chips paint spots, nothing big. There's some rust over here, here and here. But my Mark V, when I got it, it had rust from here down in a circle and all the way around back. So this is actually really in good shape. There's a little bit there too. So it's actually in really good shape. Which I'm surprised about. So anyway, the tow truck showed up quick, which I was very pleased about, and we hauled it home yesterday. So today, it's gonna get a nice cleaning, and I'm gonna power wash everything down. Obviously careful with all the chip kind of spots, but I'm gonna clean everything, clean out the interior, the engine compartment, just go to town on it, hose everything down. Also gonna get some gas for it, as well as a new battery, a proper sized battery, as well as one that's not side post, because this is top post battery. This does not have the power vent windows. The only two options that I see that are not on here are the power vent windows, and it also doesn't have the miles to empty, which is okay, because the miles to empty gauge on mine never really worked right. And apparently, the sending units are impossible to find now based on my research. But anyway, let's take a look at the inside. So yeah, this is like garage dust, like parking garage dust. I was surprised the thing started right up, but most of cars from this era usually do if they've been kept in a reasonable condition. Here's the interior. It's like very clean. Usually when I get these cars, there's like all sorts of weird stuff going on, but this one there's not, strangely enough. And so yeah, and then probably at some point someone did do the interior, but they actually did it in the proper color, which I'm very pleased about. I've seen some of these redone and the colors are like, they put like white, but it's supposed to be a dove gray, like this color. And so this is actually very nice that someone did it correctly. I think they also may have done the headliner because the headliner looks phenomenal. I'm not sure if it's original or not. Door panel's in pretty good shape. One little damaged piece of chrome. I'll probably just glue that back together. And then, of course, the little plunger thing up here needs to be replaced with the right one. A little bit of wear here and there. But for the price that I paid, I'm not going to complain. Let's take a look back here. There's a back seat. And it's not discolored, it's just the video. I'm going to wipe everything down and scrub it really well. But yeah, the interior is nice. And that's a big deal because, of course, when you get inside, you want to make sure the interior is nice. I just did the interior on my Sinatra, and it was not a cheap exercise, to be sure. But also finding the right people who can do it is actually the biggest pain. Someone put a hook there on the side of the dash for a CB radio. Like I mentioned, I think the car had an aftermarket CB radio. And then a common problem with these is the peeling of the dash, the veneer stuff. So I'll be fixing that. There's actually a kit to do this side, so I'll get that done. And let's see. And then we'll go ahead and walk around the other side here and take a look. I want to kind of do before and after pictures and video. So once we get it all cleaned up and spiffed up, missing the filler up here, which is an easy fix. But yeah, I'm planning to actually buff this out. I think it actually will come out pretty nice. And I'll get some touch-up paint and go around and touch everything up, at least for the moment. If it's salvageable, we'll go ahead and just clean it up. And then I can get the filler and just have someone paint it. I like to get everything running good first. So that's usually my thing. So, but hey, you know, if the paint's halfway decent and we can maybe buff it out, we'll go ahead and do that. It's not peeling and it's not rough, which is good. So I think there's maybe some hope for it. Tires have to go. That's actually going to be my first thing, besides the battery and the gas. The tires just are mismatched and needs white walls. Absolutely needs white walls. When I came in here yesterday, brought back a lot of memories sitting in this Mark V and of my Mark V, which was, it was a beautiful car. But this one actually is in pretty good shape. I had issues with mine, some of these same issues. So mostly the plastic stuff falling apart, stuff like that, pretty typical. Nothing to really write home about, as they say. So, yeah, a lot of these issues are pretty typical. The veneer going bad, and so on and so forth. So, thankfully, there's not a lot of those issues here. You know, not a lot of big issues, I should say. Most of it's very cosmetic. And these are actually the Pucci visors, which are very hard to get now, and it has this little signature on it. And like I said, this does not have the Miles Dampty. This does have the quadrisonic 8-track, thank goodness. And as we can see there, someone had a CB radio. We have some fading on the carpet here. It actually looks worse in the video than it does in person. But we'll figure that out eventually. Crack on the dash. We'll figure that out as well. It's not a big problem. And of course, we have the Cartier clock and all that good stuff. But no, it's in very clean shape for its age. And the interior is in good shape, which is good. some minor problems here and there, you know, some trim pieces that need to be replaced, like this. But nothing huge, nothing groundbreaking, nothing bad, and no rodent damage, which is good. And most of all, it starts right up, fires right up. But I think it's a cool car, and I like that it's a designer edition because, well, they are harder to come by, and they're definitely harder to come by. And it's kind of cool to have the designer edition Mark V. I haven't seen many of these, as crazy as that sounds. So there's the Cartier, the Givenchy, the Pucci, Bill Blass. And so I haven't seen very many of these around, the Pucci one, actually. So I think it's pretty cool. I think the production numbers were a couple thousand, 2,000-3,000 for these, but I just never see them. So I'm just wondering, well, of course it's been a long time now, but I'm just wondering where they all went. I don't know. So yeah, so we'll do some more videos on this one as it comes along. And it should be a lot of fun to clean it up and get it going again. And I'm hoping to be able to save this paint, at least temporarily. Do some touch up here and there. I think these Mark V's are great cars. I think the market is starting to catch up with them. They are very special cars. They were the last of the land yachts, the personal luxury cars that were so big. And the personal luxury cars were an interesting market, which is gone away now, and for a different time, for sure. And so I think that finally the market's just catching up with them, and it's unbelievable how much they are these days, for obviously a repaired one. This one needs some work, but I wanted one to drive around, and one that was a good foundation, where I don't have to do a whole lot to get it going. Of course, some of you guys watching this video, you'll say, I have to do a whole lot. To me, this is not a whole lot. So a lot of just cosmetic stuff. And of course, we'll get into the running of it and stuff, but the engine sounded really good. So the fact it's already running is a huge plus for me. So it's not like a paperweight just sitting here. But it's a lot of fun, and I'm happy to have a Mark V again, and thankful to my wife who bought it for me as my birthday gift. So anyway, stay tuned. We'll be doing some more with this, and it'll be a lot of fun, and I'll be posting some videos. And hope you all have a wonderful day.